Welcome to About That Business, a show where we talk to athletes that are building brands. Today's guest is Charlie Villanueva, who I sat down with just after the election in November. After 11 seasons in the NBA, Charlie is now focused on building a real estate investment empire. Let's hear how it started and how it's going.
Hey, Charlie, thanks so much for being a guest on About That Business. You know, one thing I've noticed about the NBA, which I'm sure everybody has noticed about the NBA, is this year, they've really encouraged and engaged athletes in social justice, activism, voting, opening up their facilities as polling places. What do you think about the moves they've been making to encourage players?
It's a great movement that's been going on. There's been some terrible things been going on in this world with the George Floyd situation, the whole Black Lives Matter movement. I encourage it. I think it's good that the NBA's players using their platform to create awareness, to put the movement out there, and to vote too, right? I will say this year was the first time I ever voted.
Oh my gosh, I had a confetti cannon just woo!
I'm ashamed to kind of say it, but this is the first time I did. I mean, it's better now than never. So I'm gonna let my voice be heard moving forward. And the NBA kind of helped with that. They kept preaching about voting and voting and voting. And eventually, you know, it kind of sank in and I ended up going to the polls and voted.
I'm curious to know, you know, thinking about your career, you had a long and great career in the NBA. I wonder how involved the organization itself was in preparing you for life after.
They had a bunch of awareness programs and stuff like that. This program, that program. And it's up to you at the end of the day to make, you know, put that effort in order to go to these programs, whatever field you want to go to, they have somebody or can push you to the right direction. And I have taken advantage of that, especially on the real estate side.
Well, what made you lean towards real estate?
I didn't know much about real estate at first. When I first did my first investment, I knew the ball was going to stop bouncing at some point. My dad was always preaching, invest in real estate. I was able to figure it out which path I kind of wanted to go to while I was still playing. And I ended up purchasing my first property back in 2012. You know, my dad, he reached out to me and I didn't really know nothing about it. You know, trusted my dad, and my brother was involved with it as well. So I kind of put my trust in them to kind of educate me and to kind of lead me through the process. My first property was in New York, in the Bronx, New York. It was a 3-family home. Yeah, I'm a numbers guy. And once they presented to me the deal, to me, it was like a no-brainer. I mean, that's one of the best deals I actually made because, you know, I'm still getting payments on that deal, even though I sold it back in 2018. Once I sold that and sold the type of returns I was getting, then that's when my curiosity, and then that's when, you know, I started getting more curious about, you know, pursuing this, you know, more.
Well, tell me about some early things you learned.
Once I bought that property, you know, I did a bunch of about 3 or 4 more deals with my dad and my brother in New York City. And those all turned out to be great investments. Everything was peaches and cream, I would say, right? Everything was smooth.
And then that's some foreshadowing. Dun, dun, dun.
And then, now that's when things go a different way because now I'm doing it by myself. I was like, you know what? You know, I'm living in Dallas. Why not, you know, do my investments? Why don't I invest in Dallas as well? When I started being the face of it, at first it was a headache. You know, people looked at me, oh, it's a basketball player. So what they see is dollar signs. And they can see somebody that they can probably take advantage of. They see an opportunity. I didn't know much about roofing, electrical, plumbing, foundation. But the thing was that I put my trust into the wrong contractor. It was a friend that was in the business, and you know, and then things went south where, you know, I was starting to see, you know, workers, mismanagement of funds, and workers were not going. It was lesser workers going to the properties. It was taking longer for the properties to finish. Some of the guys are saying they're not getting paid, and then I basically let them go. So now I have, you know, 5 to 6 properties that I have to figure out now. And at first it was a headache and I was super upset, super stressed. So now I have to go in there and deal with the plumbing, the electrical, the roofing, the foundation, flooring, you know, all the stuff that comes with remodeling the property. Yeah. Tough lessons I learned.
And now that you've been in it, you can't or you're less likely to be, bamboozled, hoodwinked.
Exactly. Now I can speak the same language and they can't pull one over me. You know, I didn't know much about roofing, electrical, plumbing, foundation. Call it a blessing in disguise because now it's like a crash course because I know these things now and I wouldn't have learned these things if I didn't go through it.
But what was the next move that you made to kind of branch out or solidify yourself as someone that's really in this real estate game?
So I leveraged my assets that I created in the MBA, the money, the funds that I was able to save, and I leveraged that to get loans, to get the line of credit. But at the end of the day, I can only do so much because I'm capped to a certain degree. I eventually want to get to the point where I use other people's money, but I'm still building my resume, right? I want to be more established because when I do come, I want to come correct.
It sounds to me that the way you applied yourself in real estate, having to jump in, learn on the ground, get a little dirty, get your on the ground, off the cuff understanding of this industry, it's like the hustle with getting into the NBA. What basketball skills or lessons or attitude, mentality do you apply to real estate investing?
I think communication is a must, whether it's in relationship, business, even in the locker room. But I do want to touch on one thing. You gotta be humble. You mentioned, you know, being out there and getting dirty. I remember there was a property that where I had a bunch of trash, like the workers left a bunch of trash in the backyard. I was humble enough with my fiance and I, and we picked up the trash ourselves. And it literally took me 6 hours to do it. And to me, that was a big moment. I'm on my knees picking up trash. So that was a big moment for me, and it was a super humbling experience, but it needed to be done.
And I think about, you know, the necessity of being able to play all the rules. Like you said, during that one challenging time, you had to get in and learn all of these different things about the roof, the wall, the carpet, the plumbing. And once you have that understanding, one, you have a greater respect for the people who are doing it for you. They understand who you are, and now they can't take advantage of you.
You have to lead by example, right? So here I am owning this property, but I'm coming into the property and I'm picking things up. I'm not scared to grab a hammer or do what I have to do. I'm not scared to start picking up, you know, a sledgehammer and start demoing. You know, the fact that I was in there, put my hat up, my hard hat on, and was grinding with them, you know, it just kind of gave them a whole level of respect. And it gave me, and it taught me, like, wow, like, these guys do a lot of work. So it gave me a whole different sense of appreciation for those guys. You can't accomplish anything without putting in the work. So if you're good to the game, which the basketball game, it will take care of you. So if you're good to real estate, it will take care of you.
So you're self-educated, you've been in it now. Are you mentoring players or other individuals and how to get and build wealth in real estate and investing?
All I want to do is just spread the wealth, right? I love helping others. I love, especially players, because I feel like we are targets because we have access to so many funds.
You described yourself as someone that just wants to help people. Where did that come from in you?
It comes from my parents. I'm from Queens, New York, came from the inner city of Queens, New York. My family grew up in being in welfare for 18 years, have immigrant parents. I just always had that heart where I just wanted to help others, you know, help others that are just like me, you know, that doesn't have the resources or don't have the luxury to do certain things that I can. My parents kind of instilled in me that, you know, at an early age, and I'm super thankful for that.
You've had some challenges. You had some people take you early on in your real estate career. What is some advice that you'd give to an entrepreneur? Or just if they individually want to go into real estate, what should they be looking out for?
Well, make sure whenever you are vetting a potential investor or a contractor, or whoever you're gonna do business with, make sure, don't always take their word for it. The best way to do it is to talk to other clients or other people that they've done business with, and make sure that whatever it is, like, you know, they have paperwork to back it up. And that's one thing I didn't do in the beginning. I just took people's words for things. And in the real estate business, you do not take people's word for it. Everything is with contract. Everything is, let me see the paperwork. Let me see, you know, statements. Because in this business, unfortunately, it's sad, but it's one of the easiest business where you can, you know, get over somebody, you know, and it's happened to me. So just do your due diligence. Just do your homework. I don't take any of my mistakes, you know, for granted, you know, and that's kind of what builds success, I think.
Huge thanks to Charlie for being a guest on this episode and to you for watching. Please subscribe to this channel. And for more information about this show and our upcoming guests, please like us, love us, and follow us on Facebook, LinkedIn, and Instagram. Until next time.